And of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our help is in the name of the Lord. If you, O Lord, kept a record of sin, O Lord, who could stand? Since we are gathered to hear God's word, call upon Him in prayer and praise, and receive the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ in the fellowship of this altar, let us first consider our unworthiness and confess before God and one another that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed, and that we cannot free ourselves from our sinful condition. Together as His people, let us take refuge in the infinite mercy of God, our Heavenly Father, seeking His grace for the sake of Christ, and saying, God, be merciful to me, a sinner. Almighty God, have mercy upon us, forgive us our sins, and lead us to everlasting life. Amen. Almighty God, in His mercy, has given His Son to die for you, and for His sake forgives you all your sins. As a called and ordained servant of Christ and by His authority, I therefore forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our intro for this day, as printed in your worship folder, is from Psalm chapter 25, verses 1 to 10. The congregational tune is, O Come, Emmanuel.
Lord.
world, and for the proclamation of the gospel, and the calling of all to faith, let us pray to the Lord. For this nation, for our cities and communities, and for the common welfare of us all, let us pray to the Lord. And finally, for seasonable weather and for the fruitfulness of the earth, let us pray to the Lord. Because of the weakness of our sinful nature, we can do nothing to earn salvation. Grant us the help of your grace, that we may please you with faith and obedience. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
The Old Testament reading for the 17th Sunday after Pentecost is from the book of Ezekiel, chapter 18, verses 1 through 4 and 25 through 32, and it can be found on the back of your worship folder. The word of the Lord came to me. What do you mean by repeating this proverb concerning the land of Israel? The fathers have eaten sour grapes, and the children's teeth are set on edge. As I live, declares the Lord God, the proverb shall no more be used by you in Israel. Behold, all the souls are mine, the soul of the Father as well as the soul of the Son is mine. The soul who sins shall die. Yet you say, the way of the Lord is not just. Hear now, O house of Israel, is my way not just? Is it not your ways that are not just? When a righteous person turns away from his righteousness and does injustice, he shall die. For the injustice that he has done, he shall die. Again, when a wicked person turns away from the wickedness, he has committed what is just and right. He shall save his life. Because he considered and turned away from all transgressions that he committed, he shall surely live. He shall not die. Yet the house of Israel says, the way of the Lord is not just. O house of Israel, are my ways not just? Is it not your ways that are not just? Therefore I will judge you, O house of Israel, every one according to his ways, declares the Lord God. Repent and turn from all your transgressions, lest iniquity be your ruin. Cast away from me all transgressions that you have committed, and make yourselves a new heart and a new spirit. Why will you die, O house of Israel? For I have no pleasure in the death of anyone, declares the Lord God. So turn and live. This is the word of the Lord.
If it's a lesson, or this the 17th Sunday after Pentecost, also on the back of your worship folder, from Philippians chapter 2, the verses are 1 to 4 and 14 to 18. Following the reading, we will rise and sing the Alleluia verse on page 205. First, we read together the epistle lesson. If there is any encouragement in Christ, any comfort from love, any participation in the Spirit, any affection and sympathy, complete my joy by being of the same mind, having the same love, being in full accord and of one mind. Do nothing from rivalry or conceit, but in humility count others more significant than yourselves. Let each of you look not only to his own interests, but also to the interests of others. Do all things without grumbling or questioning, that you may be blameless and innocent, children of God without blemish, in the midst of a crooked and twisted generation, among whom you shine as lights in the world, holding fast to the word of life, so that in the day of Christ I may be proud that I did not run in vain or labor in vain. Even if I am to be poured out as a drink offering upon the sacrificial offering of your faith, I am glad and rejoice with you all. Likewise, you also should be glad and rejoice with me. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please rise.
Together. I believe in one God,
Please be seated for our hymn of the day, 752.
Gift. We know what pleases
them. What gives God pleasure? What makes God happy? People worshiping Him consistently, trust in His Word, prayer, faith, love. Today we're going to delve into something we probably don't think a lot about. That is the mind of God. He lets us in there through the words of Ezekiel. What is our Lord thinking? What is God's good pleasure? Now God delights in life. We know that. He has since the beginning. He took man from dust and put air in his lungs and made him a living creature. And in the gospel, John says that whoever believes in Jesus but should not perish but have eternal life. John also tells in his gospel to have life and have it abundantly. And so we do. Now life was poured out on you at the baptismal font. You fed on the living self of Christ at the communion rail, and from this pulpit the Father speaks into your heart new life. What is God's good pleasure? That you live. Why do people die? Does death give God pleasure? Never. People die. We die because we chase our own pleasures. Repent and turn from all your transgressions, lest iniquity be your ruin. God designed us for life like His own. When we live to make ourselves happy, that is the real killer. Behold, all souls are mine, God says in our text. The soul who sins shall die. You turn down God's gift of life, and you're a goner, gone forever. You're dying because you're guilty, not because someone else sinned. That makes it very personal. The fact you will die begins and ends with you. And we can't pass that off. Ezekiel was hearing the blame game. God heard it in the Garden of Eden. Do you ever whine, life's not fair? There wasn't anything I could have done about it. Oh, the Lord could just let us wallow in that quagmire of excuse making. But He is heart struck by the accusation. God defends Himself even to us. Yet you say, the way of the Lord is not just. Hear now, O house of Israel, is my way not just? Is it not your ways that are not just? Ezekiel then quotes the Lord in the next verse, when a righteous man turns away from his righteousness and does injustice, he shall die for it. For the injustice that he has done, he shall die. There are no excuses. Still, God says, when a wicked person turns from the wickedness he has committed and does what is just and right, he shall save his life. God wants to forgive. God wants to give life. He declares, because he considered and turned away from all the transgressions that he had committed, he shall surely live. He shall not die. We need to turn away, repent, cast off all our selfish desires. And only the Lord can then create a new heart within us. We turn away from our sin to Christ's forgiveness. We cast away death. We turn to God's gift of life. The resurrected Christ has given the good news that changes everyone. God gives life. On April 26, 2006, Newell and Colleen Surratt received a phone call that their daughter Whitney, who was traveling in a Taylor University van, was involved in a crash with a semi. The van had 9 passengers and 5 were dead. The Surratt daughter Whitney was 1 of the 5. That same evening, in the home of Don and Susie Van Ryn, they were told their daughter Laura had been in the van. She was in intensive care, barely clinging to life. More than 1,000 people came to Whitney Surratt's funeral. Meanwhile, the Van Ryn family stayed at Laura's bedside. She came out of the coma. 5 weeks after the crash, her sister asked, "What's your name?" To the shock of the family, the girl they thought was Laura said, "Whitney." The coroner and the hospital had confused the 2 horribly battered young women. You see, for weeks, the Van Ryn family had believed their daughter Laura was alive. Devout Christians, the Van Ryns, now rejoice to see the Surratt family receive Whitney back from the dead. The Surratt family were also devout Christians. And 4 years later, they invited the Van Ryns to Whitney's wedding. Whitney was married in the same church where her funeral had been held. You see, God makes no mistake. The soul who sins shall die. But because He takes up the horrible load of our sins, Jesus dies for us. There's no mistake. The Lamb of God takes away the sin of the world. And why? Because the Lord your God declares that He has no pleasure in the death of anyone. So turn. Turn to Jesus and live. Live. Amen. Rise for the prayer of the church. Once again this morning, at the end of the petitions, I will say the words, "Lord, in your mercy, will you, as the congregation of Christ, please respond, hear our prayer." O Lord, we are your people, chosen by your grace to be your own possession, and granted mercy upon mercy. Hear your people who cry to you in need, and remember us according to the favor you have shown to us in Jesus Christ our Lord. Make us to know your ways, O Lord, that we may walk in the path of salvation made known in your word. Hear our complaints and quiet them by your merciful deliverance, that we may respond with trust and thanksgiving. Lord, in your mercy, encourage us, O Lord, by your Holy Spirit, that we may not lose heart, But being of one mind and one will, we may serve you with gladness, doing the works of your kingdom, and speaking your word of witness throughout the world. Lord, in your mercy, enlighten us with godly knowledge and wisdom, O Lord, and bless those who pursue science to improve our lives and the lives of those in greatest need. Bless all honorable vocations and all honest labor, and lead the unemployed to good jobs and noble work, not only for their own interests, but for the good of us all. Lord, in your mercy, we thank and praise you, Lord, for calling home this past week. Excuse me. We praise you, Lord, and we thank you and give you praise and thanksgiving for being with Marvin Hood, who was hospitalized this past week. And we ask, Lord, that you would continue to heal him. We thank you that he is now out of the hospital, that you would watch over and guide and bless him and continue to be with him. Lord, in your mercy. We also thank and praise you, Lord, that you saw to it that Shirley Potter made the journey home this past week. After her suffering a massive stroke, we know, Lord, that she was called home. This was her final journey here on earth as she passed from death to life. We thank you, Lord, and we praise you. We ask now that you would comfort and give peace to the family of Shirley, that you would watch over them in the days and weeks ahead. Remind them of the resurrection that you brought about through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Continue to be with them, Lord, in your mercy. Into your hands, Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our worship will continue now on page 208 with our service in the sacrament, the preface. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly good, right, and salutary we should at all times and in all places give thanks to you, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and everlasting God, for the countless blessings you so freely bestow on us and all creation. Above all, we give thanks for your boundless love shown to us when you sent your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, into our flesh and laid on him our sin, giving him into death, that we might not die eternally. Because he is now risen from the dead and lives and reigns through all eternity, all who believe in him will overcome sin and death and will rise again to new life. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and singing. Blessed are you, O Lord, our God, King of all creation, for you have had mercy on us. Given your only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. In your righteous judgment, you condemned the sin of Adam and Eve, who ate the forbidden fruit. You justly barred them and all their children from the tree of life, yet in your great mercy, you promised salvation by a second Adam, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and made his cross a life-giving tree for all who trust in him. We give you thanks for the redemption you have prepared for us through Jesus Christ. Grant us your Holy Spirit that we may faithfully eat and drink of the fruit of his cross and receive the blessings of forgiveness, life, and salvation that come to us in his body and blood. Hear us as we pray in his name and as he has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ, in the night when he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." In the same way also he took the cup after supper. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Yeah. the body and the blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, strengthen and preserve you, the one true faith, unto life everlasting. Depart in peace. Amen.
once again. Last night I was at my dad's and an aunt and uncle from Oklahoma were there, and I was wowing them with my knowledge of my family, like people nobody could remember. And the Lord keeps us humble, as you saw today in the prayers. I apologize for that. I sort of just lost my place and who I was supposed to be praying for. So anyway, the Lord does that to us and keeps us in our place and reminds us He's in charge. So my apologies about that. Then I want to let you know about the Portals of Prayer. If you haven't picked up your copy yet, the new Portals of Prayer starts with the October, and October is this week. So you can pick those up over in the rack in the narthex. Does anyone have any other announcements this morning? All right, Carson will usher you out again from back to front once I get out. And the peace of the Lord be with you. Thanks.